Skyline in front of us, a look at Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. Should be a fun Father's Day matchup between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Philadelphia Phillies. Which of these two will prevail? Next on the show. Chris Acho, a West Virginian, gets the call to start this one. EK, what's the word on him?
Yeah, Maddie, in his last start, he had a ton of strikeouts. He'll be looking to duplicate that effort here.
Ender Inciarte makes his way to the plate, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Left fielder, Ender Inciarte.
And we are underway this afternoon as the first pitch is over for a called strike one. Eric, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, they're coming off another victory last time out, and now they're winners of 8 of their last 9 ball games.
And they've got themselves a pretty good-sized lead in the division coming into play. Certainly not out of reach yet, but they've got to be pretty comfortable with where they're sitting at this point in the year.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Fastball swung on and missed, and the leadoff man has gone on strikes to start the afternoon. Time now to look at the Diamondbacks' starting lineup. EK, any thoughts?
Oh, man, I love what A.J. Pollock does for this offense. He went deep last game, and he seems ready to take advantage of any mistakes he sees right now.
Andres Cordero will stand in, and as you can see, the numbers away from home, he's been much better once he gets out on the road. Here's the first pitch to him. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. The rain, as we've mentioned, coming down fairly steadily here at game time. EK, how'd you like playing in the rain?
It wasn't that bad. The only problem, sometimes up at the plate, batting gloves would get wet while it was raining. It made it a little difficult to hit.
And that misses 2-2.
I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
Hit on the ground to short. Franco has it. Oh, and he overshoots his first baseman as it's over his head. And now, oh, this ball's going to wind up out of play. And a big mistake there.
Well, this is just something you hate to see early in the ballgame. Just a second batter of the game, and already these guys are throwing the ball away. Hope that's not a sign of things to come.
Stepping in now, Rafael Vasquez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
And you know, all you have to do is point back to yesterday's ball game. This was part of their downfall, hitting with runners in scoring position. They just couldn't sustain any kind of offense. So this would be a big boost if he could turn the tide a little bit here and come through big.
Nope. And he misses with it, 1-1.
And I think they'd stay out there again, maybe for the rest of the at-bat.
One and one, here it is. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. And set up working the plate is Larry Bullard, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Well, my man Larry, he's solid. Rarely do many people get upset with his calling of the strike zone because it doesn't really seem like he favors any one part of the zone more than another.
Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. One out and a runner on second base. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. And with a quick breather here, let's take a look at how the Phils will set up on D. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, they know their man on the hill has more strikeouts than anybody in the National League. Sometimes that can make you a little bit lazy out in the field. You just start watching swings and misses. You've always got to be on your toes, though, because the ball will be put in play, and you're going to have to be ready for it.
A.J. Pollock stands in as he can't connect here, 0-1.
Well, you know, you hear it all the time because it's true. First pitch strikes are so important. It really changes the complexion of the at-bat for not only the pitcher but the hitter as well, especially when you've got a good hitter up there.
Here comes the 0-1. And there's ball one.
That trying to go front door with that breaking ball started it a little too far inside, though.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And a curveball is by him that time as he falls behind now 1-2.
That's the beauty of having an open base. You can work that pitch off the plate and try and get him to chase, and it worked out there.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. The 1-2 pitch. Chop foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One left for the Diamondbacks. Now it'll be the Phillies' turn. No score. Patrick Corbin will be the one towing the rubber for the Diamondbacks. Eric, any thoughts?
Well, guys, he's having a real consistent year. He's got an ERA under 3. Anytime you're doing something like that, you're doing just fine.
Brock Holt comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half
leading
of the first.
For the Phillies, left fielder, Brock Holt.
.92 splits the plate, and it's strike one. EK, these Diamondbacks as they begin play. It was another loss last time out, and this portion of the schedule has not done them any favors as they've dropped 5 of their last 7.
Yeah, and the pitching really let them down last time. Too often their guys were falling behind and having to throw fastballs on 2-0 or 3-1. That'll catch up with you after a while.
Rips this one to first, and this continues right on through him as he couldn't knock it down. The relay, and he is in there.
He's safe.
Pretty safe to say he was sitting on the fastball there. He's out in front of this pitch, and he just drills it right down the line, and that'll put him in a good position here with the runner on second and nobody out.
Drew Stubbs will make his way in now as you get a look at his splits there on your screen. In tight here with the first pitch fastball, that's 1-0. Too high, ball two.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. Two close pitches, two good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
3-0 now. He's set. Here's the 3-0. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. Set to deal. Here's the 3-1. And opposite field as he lines this down the line in right. And they're going to strike first this afternoon as this is down for extra bases. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Oh, an early strike here in the opening inning as they get that first run on the board with back-to-back doubles. No question, they'd love to push this out to a 2-run lead or maybe even more. So with another dangerous hitter coming up, they've got an opportunity to do just that.
Brandon Jordan will stand in, and as you can see, it's another early RBI opportunity for the National League leader in that category.
Yeah, and you guys know he's definitely been one of the best run producers in the sport over the last several weeks. I'm sure his guys are hoping that he can keep it up all the way into the fall.
Hit to short. And they will not get him at first as he's able to leg out the throw.
Well, you know you're talking about a nice streak when you get up over 10 games in a row, and now that's 11 for this guy, so he is feeling it.
Michael Franco will stand in here with a chance to pad his RBI total, and as you can see, he currently sits third in the National League in that category.
And you got to love it when you have a shortstop that can produce such big offensive numbers for you. That usually isn't the case.
Here comes the first pitch. Pretty well struck high and deep to left field. Ranging back is Inciarte. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. Around third and being waved on home. And the run is in to score from second. And not in time as the second run scores.
Well, you know you're talking about a nice streak when you get up over 10 games in a row. And now that's 11 for this guy, so he is feeling it.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Comes into his first at-bat at 283. 8 home runs, 26 RBIs. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Would you say he's not really finishing his pitches at this point?
That's a good way to put it. It looks like he's aiming a little too much, and that's not working for him.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And the run will cross on the sack fly and make it a 4-0 game.
Well, it's been a big inning already, and they tack on another run here on the sacrifice fly. But at this point, I think defensively, you're just happy to take an out.
Adrian Beltre steps in, and he's really been feeling it at the plate the last week or so. Definitely a guy to keep your eye on right now. First delivery to him on the way. Had him reach in that time. It's strike one.
And now, even with 4 runs in against you here in the inning, you got to just wipe the slate clean and just take the approach that you're starting over out there.
The windup and the 0-1. And he falls behind 0-2. 4 runs here in this half inning. And Beltre wisely lays off that one, 1-2.
Well, that's a pitch right there that you've got to lay off. You know he's going to throw it on an 0-2, and that's a good job of pitch recognition right there.
Now a ball hit foul off to the right side, and that just about got the first base coach. One and two, here it comes. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Fought off at the plate and we'll do it again. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. A moment now to check out the hometown Phil's starting lineup. Who's the one to watch, EK?
Well, I'm always excited when I get to see Adrian Beltre do his thing. He sports a batting average with runners in scoring position over 300, so you could say he relishes in those big moments. We'll see if that's the case in this one.
Darren Ruff. We'll dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. And that swung on and missed for strike one.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
I think generous is the word here. That looked like it was 6 inches off the plate.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. Chop foul over towards the dugout. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Yeah, sort of a pesky at-bat up there. You know he'd just love to fire one more fastball by this guy and be done with this inning.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
And this is a hallmark of this ball club. They grind out their at-bats. They're going to make you throw a ton of pitches.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit sharply toward the right side. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is really starting to heat up now. That's eight straight games with a base hit. He's been fun to watch.
Freddie Galvis digs in for the first time now and looking to break out of this little six-game dry spell at the plate. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
Well, he's really had to work hard here in this first inning. You got to wonder, how much is that going to take out of him?
Oh, and one count and the pitch. And it's quickly 0-2. Up to an even 30 pitches here in the first inning. A little bit off the outside, it's 1-2. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. And that gets down, and we'll see if that's extra bases. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Boy, he has really taken a pounding out there. That's six hits now he's given up in just this inning alone, and it's beyond time for a change. You've got to get him out of there.
Chris Tacho will stand in with a chance to help himself out big time here with a couple of men in scoring position.
And a lot of times, pitchers go up there just because they sort of have to. But here, if you go up and just think ground ball up the middle, you might get one home, maybe two. So this is a big time change.
From the stretch, lays off 1-0.
And this is a spot where you got a chance to put away a team early. So this becomes a very important at-bat for both teams.
Here comes the 1-0. That one will get out of play, and the count evens up at 1-1. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Runners at second and third with two gone. Squared that one up just a little late. Liner towards second. That gets down, and the inning will continue. And the run is in to score from third. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from second. It's a 6-0 ball game.
Well, you know that old saying, anybody with a bat in his hand is dangerous. And sure enough, it's the pitcher that comes through here, and he drives in two.
Brock Holt will get his second shot at it now. He doubled to start out the home first.
Well, he hit the fastball, so we're going to see right here if they still come at him with the hard stuff.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Fly ball heading for the alley. On the move is Pollock, but he can't get there. This splits the outfielders and heads toward the wall. Around third and being waved on home. And the run will score all the way from first. It's 7-0.
Well, I might not have been ready to declare this one over a minute ago, but now a 7-0 lead in the first. This one is O-B-E-R over. I hope folks weren't late in arriving because they're going to get a shock when they see that scoreboard.
Bruce Stubbs stands in after hitting an RBI double his first time around.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. Oh, high, deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Seven home runs for him on the year now as they push this lead up to 9 now.
Pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
Now the Diamondback skipper's up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he'll make his way to the dugout here as he'll turn things over to the bullpen from here on out.
Daniel Hudson
will go to work much earlier than anticipated here as he'll try and sort this mess out in the very first inning.
The batter, right fielder, Brandon Jordan.
Standing in now, Brandon Jordan, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. That look says it all in the third base dugout.
That's not the look of a guy who's going to be sleeping well tonight, is it?
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. To two balls and two strikes now. Struck him out. And the inning finally comes to a close. But not before they hang a nine spot on him here to really open up this ball game. We'll move to inning number two here in Philadelphia. Phillies on top, 9-0. Danny Valencia will stride forward to lead it off. And I'd imagine he'll do so with some tired legs after being out in the field for that last half inning.
Yeah, that was a killer. He could probably use a minute or two on the bench, but he gets pressed right back into action here.
First offering on its way. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one.
I think he had to take that one because I'm not even sure he saw it.
Here's the 0-1 pitch. Here's a late swing and a miss. Strike two.
Boys, that's 99 right through him.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. 0-2, here it comes. And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
And I think that might have been a little bit of a purpose pitch right there up in the zone. Now I think he's going to come back down with something to try to get that strikeout.
I just tried to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2.
I'll give him this. He's not intimidated up there. Well, that was inside. Close to triple digits. He didn't even flinch.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Well, it's been something of a strikeout fest here to start this game off. Already four strikeouts now in the first five batters. Now that's going to be a tough pace to keep up.
Into the box now, Quentin Berry. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. But come into play at 317. Two home runs and six RBIs. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
He's just working east and west here. He'll be fine if he just stays out of the middle.
Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
And even on 0-2, you don't want guys to get into a comfort level up there.
One out, nobody on. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Two. ground ball right side. A flip from short right gets him, and there are two away.
Batting seven.
Yeah, and he had to range deep for this one. And you've also got to worry about that ball hitting the lip of the outfield grass. So you got to hang with it just like he did, and he made a nice play.
Chris Owings will stand in, and as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against the southpaws than he does against right-handers. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1.
Well, he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't gonna help.
The 0-1. Hit in the air to right field. Jordan under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They're down 9-0. Michael Franco will start things off in the home second. And they got to be licking their chops after that first inning output.
Yeah, and I think if you're a guy getting your second at-bat of the game and it's only the second inning, you know things are going pretty well.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Righty against righty as this is taken for a ball. It's 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Hit hard down the line toward the coaching box. It's a foul ball. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1. Due up next is Salvador Perez. Set. Here's the 3-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And that's going to land foul. Goes the other way and sends it deep down the right field line. But that'll be off the right field wall. And he's 2-for-2 as he's in there with a double.
Boy, just another great swing right there. And he's had a few of them in this series. He gets a good pitch to hit, and he's right on it. And he drives this one off the wall for an easy double. And it might be time for them to let somebody else beat you for a change.
Into the box, Salvador Perez earned himself an RBI with a sac fly his last time at the plate. Slapped hard the opposite way. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit. Around third and being waved on hold. And not in time as the run scores.
The third baseman, number 29.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Adrian Beltre. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
Hit sharply on the ground to the left. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And they will not be able to get the force at second, so there are two on now to start the inning.
First baseman, Darren Ruff.
Settling in now, Darren Ruff. He reached on a single in his first try.
And I think we mentioned it already, but that extended his hitting streak, swinging a hot bat right now.
And he lays off there 1-0.
Well, you know, three straight hits are bad enough, but now he's making things even worse by falling behind the next guy.
The 1-0 delivery. This one's a strike. It's 1-1.
And you know, I think it's going to be important that when guys get their pitches, they take advantage. There it looked like he was taken all the way, and he may not get another pitch that catches that much of the plate.
Here's the 1-1. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Yeah, right back to that inside location. When a guy shows you he can't handle a tough slider on the hands, you can bet that guy on the mound, he's going to go right back to that pitch before too long.
Now a ball hit sharply toward third. And that is a fair ball as this one's heading for the left field corner. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate.
Tack on another run there. They put up 11 now in the ball game. And this offense is definitely running on all cylinders.
Digging in, Freddie Galvis. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, it's been an offensive explosion for him today, and let's see if they can keep it going.
Oh, that one got the pitcher. Throw gets him, so they are able to get an out on an unusual play, and hopefully the pitcher's okay. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Chris Acho will get a shot now in an RBI spot, so a chance to help his own cause here.
And he's got a hit in the game already, so he can handle the bat at least a little bit.
He's set. Here it comes. Here's a slider to start things out. Looked at for ball one. And he misses low with it. 2-0.
This is the kind of inning he's not pitching efficiently. He's just trying to be too darn fine, not trusting his stuff.
Two and oh pitch on the way. Outside and low, 3-0.
Of all the people to lose the strike zone against in this lineup, he's got to be out there thinking, how is this happening against the pitcher?
Runners are at second and third with one down. And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
Don't be surprised if he still doesn't have the green light on 3-1.
Here it is on 3-1. And the count will be full. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Vasquez is there for it. Two gone. With a moment now, let's bring in a look at the defensive alignment for the Diamondbacks. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, A.J. Pollock brings exceptional defense into the outfield. He won the Gold Glove in 2015, patrolling center field. There's nothing boring about the way he plays. Very aggressive, shows a lot of energy, and you can really go get him with the best of them.
Brock Holt stands in, looking to build off that RBI double from his last plate appearance.
Well, he did a good job to go down and get one in his last at-bat, but I got to think he'll be looking for a pitch that he can drive right here.
First pitch is a changeup for a called strike.
Oh, and he knows he let one get away right there. He may not see a better pitch to do some damage with all afternoon.
Oh and one, here it comes. One and one. A little bouncer. On to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. So it's two runs on four base hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. We've played two full. It's the Phillies 11 and the Diamondbacks nothing. Cesar Hernandez will come forward now. Back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off.
Cesar Hernandez.
Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
And you know, you get stuck sometimes being that number eight hitter trying to work the count and trying to buy a little extra time for your pitcher. Now that's a pitch right down the middle that maybe a number four hitter jumps all over.
A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. And another foul ball. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Ready on 1-2. And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Paul Goldschmidt will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning.
Paul Goldschmidt.
And that misses inside 1-0.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now, and that's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
Diamondbacks still searching for that first hit of the ballgame. Sneaks a fastball by him at the letters. It's 1-1.
100 miles an hour is hard. A high 100, impossible to get on top of.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
And he's just running right through these guys. Absolutely worn him down.
Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2.
That's three straight pitches all over 100 miles an hour. If he throws a changeup for a strike here, that guy's got no chance.
Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Now a swing and a miss on a pitch well out of the strike zone as he becomes the second out.
I'm not quite sure what that was all about. I don't think he knows either. That was almost in the on-deck circle.
Ender Inciarte will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
And he takes a cold strike, 0-1.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Two out, nobody on. Fooled him a bit as this is hit high in the air towards right center and shallow. Jordan is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Diamondbacks down in order. They trail in this one 11-0. Ruby De La Rosa is going to come on to pitch here, and seeing as though it's just the third inning, he may be asked to work for a while.
De La Rosa.
Riding into the box, Drew Stubbs. He went deep in his first at bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
Oh, and guys, he absolutely hammered that pitch. Are you talking about a long home run? They all count the same, but goodness gracious, was that thing hit.
Ball. 2-0.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at-bat. Normally, this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Hit hard up the middle. And that'll get on through into center field, so he's got himself a leadoff single.
Well, he's homered. He's doubled, and now he adds a single to that total. He's left himself with the toughest leg of the cycle remaining, but he'll at least have a chance to pick up that fourth and final leg next time through the order.
Into the box, Brandon Jordan. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. Throw over to first, but the runner's back easily.
Simple throw over there.
That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however, and a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Well, it probably wasn't the way he wanted to move the guy into scoring position, but it's going to have to do, and he's going to get that man up to second base now with one away.
Michael Franco steps in here. He'll look to keep it going after hitting a double and scoring a run last time up.
And that came after a long battle at the plate. And he was able to stay patient and finally got a pitch that he could drive.
And here's a fastball called for strike one.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
De La Rosa pauses. Here's the 0-1. And that misses 1-1. Drilled to the left side. And just past his outstretched glove into left, the base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Yeah, he's got his first single of the ballgame here to go along with the double and a triple from earlier. So what do you think, guys? In his next at-bat, he absolutely comes out of his shoes trying to get the homer.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
Pretty cool right there. You know, it's so important in a tough spot to get that first pitch strike over, and he's able to jump ahead.
And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Hit to third. Scooped up. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. We're back in Philadelphia right after this. Andres Cordero is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
Well, you know, they've fallen behind by quite a bit in the early going here, so they need a good inning here to get them back in the game.
And who? Looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's nothing and one. Pitch on the way. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Now the 0-2 pitch. Bounced softly in front of the plate. Perez gonna have to hurry. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
How about it?
Yeah, and you know, that's a nice play back there behind the plate. For a big guy, look how quickly he springs to his feet, gets rid of that mask, and then he finds the ball here to make the throw to first to get his man.
In now, Rafael Vasquez, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. Fastball called for strike two.
Right back, same pitch, also knee high. He wasn't buying that one either. He's gonna have to do something now. He's down two strikes.
Diamondbacks still searching for that first hit of the ballgame. Line toward the alley in left center. And that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances.
I tell you, that one's coming in fast, but it's going out faster. Does he square this one up or what?
You bet he does.
Standing in now, A.J. Pollock. Now a pitch popped up. Should be enough room for Perez behind the plate. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
Well, we could hear him all the way up here in the booth. Just a big old... that's what pop-ups will make you do.
Danny Valencia is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen sometimes.
And a fastball is in there for strike one. No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Too high. Now, 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
trying to strike him out for the second time. 1-2 is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Chop foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. A runner on first with two away. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. One left for Arizona. They trail in this one 11-0. Adrian Beltre is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Well, guys, they jumped out to that big lead early on in this game, but you really can't get comfortable. You have to keep putting pressure on.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. A good tailing fastball for a strike, 1-1. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to left. Inciarte's there. One out.
First baseman number 19, Darren Ruff.
Darren Ruff steps in after hitting an RBI single his last time around. De La Rosa sets his sights. Here's the first pitch. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0. Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. Bases are empty, one man out. High and away, not close. 3-0.
He's definitely looking fastball there, and you know, he got one, but good recognition not to go up and chase it.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
And at the plate, he might have been told, look, you're taken until you get a strike. It's not a bad idea.
That's popped up. Now towards short right field. Berry over to his left. Makes the play, and there are two gone now.
The batter, second baseman, ready, Galvis.
Stepping in, Freddie Galvis, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
He has really struggled against right-handed pitching so far this year. His average against righties is pretty ugly so far.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he will indeed make the play in foul territory to retire the side. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. But they lead it 11-0. Quentin Berry heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Boy, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
Into the windup and the pitch. Drilled to the right side. A dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield.
Just the second hit they've got against him so far as we check on his numbers to this point. He's pretty much been in control all afternoon, so we'll see if he can keep that string of zeros going.
Chris Owings is at the plate now, flied out in his first at-bat. first pitch of the at-bat. Right side, hit hard. He gets dirty, but he can't make the play. It's a base hit.
Let's train our show motion camera on that runner at first base. Here, he might have had a shot to get around to third, but you see him have to hold up to make sure the baseball doesn't hit him. And by the time he gets going again, he knows he'll have to hold on at second base.
Cesar Hernandez will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
And this is taken outside for ball one.
Now with two on and nobody out, it's looking like this scoreless string could be in some jeopardy.
A ball and no strikes, here it is. In for a strike, it's one and one.
Ooh, that is one of the best he's thrown this afternoon.
One and one, here it comes. That's lifted the other way out to left. Holt is there, one down.
Well, that's back-to-back curveballs right there, and he couldn't really square either of them up, and he's retired easily on the fly.
Mark Trumbo will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 15, Mark Trumbo.
A swing and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here.
Well, normally you prefer your hitters to be aggressive, but this was a situation where it really cost him. He's got two men on base, but he winds up chasing the first pitch out of the zone, pops it straight up.
Ender Inciarte digs in, and we'll see what he can do here with two on and two out here in the fifth.
Yeah, a couple of ducks on the pond out there looking to make that trip home. This is a big two-out AB right here, guys.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. And he takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two. Boy, that changeup's had him eaten out of his hand.
Oh, and they've been falling all over themselves trying to get it. But you've just got to know that that's not going to be a strike. It looks like it is, but it isn't.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses one and two.
Still now on one and two, you don't have to make the perfect pitch out there. The count is still well in your favor on the mound.
Two down, runners at first and second. Cue shot here out towards short. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for naught. We're back with more on a Sunday afternoon following this. Guy Callahan is going to take over here in inning number five as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep him in the game here.
Callahan.
Chris Acho will stand in. He singled and popped out in his first two at-bats.
Etcher, Chris Acho.
And that's taken for strike one. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Tap foul at home plate. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy up, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you're not making contact, though.
Here's Brock Holt now. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Nope. Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
One ball, one strike.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And a good pitch there as he got him to go after one in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Yeah, that's where you need to be selective. That was a pitcher's pitch, and now you give that advantage right back.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
I'd say he's made a pretty good impression since coming on. Two batters, two strikeouts to start the inning.
Drew Stubbs strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Into the seats, 0-1. Chop foul right at home plate. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. More from Citizens Bank Park in just a moment. Andres Cordero will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Swing and a miss at a first pitch changeup. Nothing in one.
All afternoon long, this is what we've seen. Guys have just dug their own hole up there by going after pitches that aren't strikes.
And low, it's a ball and a strike. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Hit hard back up the middle. And this is going to scoot on through into center for a base hit leading off the inning.
Oh, you better have to pay attention to this guy right now. He is heating it up. Seven straight games now with that hit.
Vasquez.
Rafael Vasquez will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. First pitch on its way. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Now here's a good spot to finally break through against this guy. You've got the leadoff man on, the heart of the order's coming up, and maybe this is a good chance to get that goose egg off the scoreboard.
Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Not close, it's 2-0.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
That's going to even up the count at 2-2. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
And into his 6th inning of work now. Let's take a look at the breakdown for him so far.
Center fielder, A.J. Pollock.
A.J. Pollock will stand in. He struck out and popped out in 2 trips.
Well, not a great start at the plate. We'll see if he can get something to drive right here.
Starts him out with a changeup for a strike.
This guy has been amazing. He's thrown a first pitch strike to around 80% of the batters he faced. And we're in the middle innings now, so you know he's doing well.
Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. A 1-1 count, here's the pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Jordan giving chase, and that's the second out of the inning.
Boy, his guy's got him the lead back in the very first inning, and he hasn't looked back since. He's had everything go his way so far, and this inning's turning out to be no exception.
Danny Valencia, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
Yeah, and they fanned him on a fastball last time, so let's see if they come at him with the hard stuff again.
And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
And this offense has just been stuck in neutral. Even when they get a guy on to start the inning, they've got nothing to go with it.
No runs, 4 hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. And that's in there as well, 0-2 now.
Well, no taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. And a good pitch there, but it's taken for a ball, and it's 2-2 to the Arizona third baseman. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. One left for the Diamondbacks. They trail in this one 11 to nothing. Brandon Jordan will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so against a guy who's definitely in a groove out there.
Yeah, he struck out the side his last time through, and they've got to do something to get this guy out of the role that he's been on.
And now some action in that Arizona bullpen, as it looks like they'll have both a lefty and a righty up to throw. Sent toward first, leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done.
Nice play there. Not always easy on a soft liner like that, but he waited, and then he got up there to make the play.
Into the box now, Michael Franco. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. One oh count, here it is. And a strike to even the count. One and one. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. Throwing a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
That's a ball. High and wide. Two balls and a strike.
Looks like they're showing a bit more respect to that guy up there. That's what a 3-for-3 ball game will do for you.
And the pitch on 2-1. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Grounded down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Hit hard on the ground to the right, and this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Man, he is wearing them out. Got himself a 4-for-4 afternoon.
Salvador Perez comes forward to bat again. He was the victim of a double play last time around.
Yeah, and it's always kind of tough returning to the dugout after rolling into a double play. So you know he wants to make up for that one right here.
He's set and the pitch. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone and is probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
That evens it up 1-1.
Salvador Perez is a multiple Gold Glove winner behind the plate, including in 2015, but he can definitely do some damage with the bat as well.
Here it comes on 1-1. On a big swing, and he crushes this ball deep. My goodness, a long home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Home run number 9 on the year as the blowout continues.
Just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
David Hernandez will come on now to try and sort this mess out, as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here.
The third baseman, number 29.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre, as he takes a called strike on the black. It's 0-1. Oh, and Beltre really wanted that one, but he didn't get it. Behind 0-2 now.
And this is exactly what he does so well. He'll make you so convinced that you're going to see a fastball, and then he's going to go the other way on you.
And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
And that's his strikeout pitch right there. You know, you'll see a lot of guys swing right over the top of that one. That's a great job there just to hold off.
A good curveball that time as it's taken for a called strike three, and there are two away.
Nothing better for your confidence than to come right in out of the bullpen and strike that first guy out. A lot of times, that'll set the tone for your whole outing.
Stepping in now, Darren Ruff. He takes the changeup the other way out toward right center. Pollock on the run. And the inning is over. Another good inning here for the Phillies, and the brotherly love is in abundance now. On to the back third here this afternoon, and we've got it for you on the show. Welcome back to Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. This one pretty much all over, but the shouting as we check our game summary to see how we've gotten to where we are. Quentin Berry will dig in, one for two. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Well, he started off this way and he continues on. He's throwing first pitch strikes to 80% of the batters he's faced, and we're late in this ballgame, and that's why he's on top.
The 0-1 on its way. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
And this is going back to the pattern he's been using here lately. Set him up inside and then get him out with pitches away.
To two balls and two strikes now. Sent on the ground out to second. Fielded by Galvis, and the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
Shortstop, Chris Owings.
Chris Owings will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
High in the air out to center field. Stubbs is under it. Two down.
You know, that's the thing with throwing a fastball as hard as he does. It makes fly balls travel that much farther off the bat. And this thing gets out there a long ways before it finally gets tracked down.
Cesar Hernandez will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out 0 for 2 thus far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one.
I like how he's approaching things here. He's got a good, safe lead, so he's not setting guys up or wasting a lot of pitches. He's coming right after everybody.
Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
He's closing in on putting up yet another zero.
And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. Still looking up at a 13-0 score. Freddie Galvis steps into the box as the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the seventh.
Second baseman, Freddie Galvis.
Hit out toward second. Hernandez takes it in. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Now batting, pitcher, Chris Acho.
Chris Acho will buy himself another at-bat, and in turn, he'll get himself a nice little ovation for the work he's turned in on the mound so far.
He's been great. This is an appreciative crowd. They like what they've seen, and I don't blame them.
Here's the pitch. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. Fastball at 96 on the radar gun, and it's 1-1. He'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
This guy is almost no threat up at the plate. I mean, you could get away with fastballs right down the middle if you wanted to.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. One out, nobody on. Check to swing there and pops this one up. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out.
This is a gift right here. He can't make up his mind whether to go after this pitch or not. So he does the worst thing you can do, which is go for it halfway.
Here's Brock Holt now. As he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. Philadelphia is on top, 13-0. Will Middlebrooks is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the 8th.
Will Middlebrooks.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Well, that man right there is into his 8th inning of work now. Any concerns going forward?
Well, I think the only thing you have to worry about is that pitch count you see right there. Other than that, he's earned the right to stay out there. Usually the other team will tell you when you're starting to get tired.
A high strike there, and it's 1-1. Time to be alert for signs of tiring here in the 8th. He's a pitch away from 100. One and two. I'll tell you, he's been living on that corner all afternoon.
And you can tell, guys at the plate, they're starting to get frustrated. He just hasn't made many mistakes at all. And when he has, they've been out of the zone.
ground ball sent back up the middle. And that's going to be a base hit. So a great job off the bench, and he's aboard here to lead off the inning.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now, so he may be getting just a little bit tired.
Ender Inciarte will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Yeah. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Nobody out, runner on first. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Holt waits on it, one away. Something to be said for home cooking, apparently, as you get a look at our line score. This one never in doubt, as the home standing nine have outplayed their guests in every facet of the game. Digging in, Andres Cordero. He singled his last time up. From the stretch. And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half. Here's the 0-1. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Runners on first with one down. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
And again, they try to take him down in the strike zone just to see if he'll go after that pitch below the knees. But with two strikes, he's been able to lay off that thing now twice in a row.
Still 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Such a good at-bat right here. When you can grind out seven, eight pitches against a guy that's running short on gas, that can be huge.
On the ground to second base, this could be two. To second for one. On the first, it's a double play as their woes continue. The inning is over. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. More to come on the show Sunday Baseball after this. Brad Ziegler will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Ziegler. So standing in, Drew Stubbs. And we'll see if he can get something into the gap to make it interesting. He's had a great game so far, but needs the triple to complete a cycle.
And you know, that's the toughest one to get in a cycle, but you can bet that he's going to try to stretch any double into a triple if he gets any chance at all.
And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. And we're going to have a quick stoppage here as a beach ball has made its way into right field. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting toward the third base dugout. One away.
That's a disappointing final at-bat there. You figure he probably won't get another shot at finishing off the cycle, but still a very good performance to say the least.
Brandon Jordan digs in now after lining out in his last try.
And Matt, you know what? It's always a little frustrating when you square one up, you hit a solid live drive somewhere, and all you get to show for it is a nice little jog right back to the dugout. That can get in your head a little bit after a while.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. Chop foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. Bases are empty, one man out. That misses, says the home plate umpire. 1-2. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure.
Not too sure how you take that one on 0-2.
Yeah, I'm not too sure how you call it a ball either.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Well, it looked like he had things in control to start him out. Well, now he's run it from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last one wasn't even close.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count remains 3-2. And he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
And for as hot as this guy's been recently, this is a no-brainer. Take the bat out of his hands any chance you get.
Oliver Perez will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Michael Franco will step forward now following the walk as he'll hit with a definite speed threat at first and one away.
You can bet he's going to see some fastballs in this at-bat. I'd be looking dead red.
A look by Perez, now the pitch. And he's no doubt searching for a ground ball here as this sinker dips below the knees. It's 1-0. Runner at first here, one man out. Now a check swing here, but the home plate umpire says he went around. And no argument, and it's 1-1. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Strike two called, and it's even at two. Now a snap throw to first. And he'll get back in standing. Smoke toward the hole. That's through for a base hit, and he's putting together a monster line in this one. They just can't get him out.
Boy, and they have not been able to get him out. This is now a five-hit ball game for him here, and those don't come along every day.
Ready to take his hacks again, Salvador Perez, as he'll look to follow up the two-run homer he launched over the wall last time up.
Well, the last time he saw a fastball and hit it pretty well, so we'll see how they work him this time. You can throw him more fastballs, but you better not put it in that location.
First pitch here is a sinker that runs a bit too wide. It's ball one. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's one and one.
Oh, that's a good fastball right there, and you had to figure that he was looking for that sinker.
A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Chop foul at the plate, and we'll do it again. On the ground up the middle. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. And the runner from second is in to score.
And this offensive explosion continues. They're now up to 14 runs in the game. You can't even count that high. And I think defensively, you got to be saying right now, what do we got to do to get these guys out?
Into the box now, Adrian Beltre. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Well, you know, it never feels good to go down on strikes, especially looking. I wouldn't be surprised to see him be a little more aggressive in this at-bat.
He's set. Now the pitch. Now a fastball to start things out. Didn't miss by a lot, but it's 1-0. The set and the 1-0 pitch. That hole getting a little deeper now. It's 2-0.
Boy, he better get it back together here with two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
Ready with the 2-0 pitch. Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now.
Oh, and he's sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in the matter of about 5 feet.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. 3-1 now.
And up at the plate now, he's really in the driver's seat. I don't think they want to walk him, so this should be something good.
Ready on 3-1. Here it comes. And there's a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Here comes the payoff pitch. Grounded back up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run's in to score from third.
And the beat goes on. Another great at-bat, and what else is new? They've now thrown 15 runs up on the scoreboard. Now that is a good day's work.
Addison Reed will come on and try to get out of this mess here as there are two on with only one away.
Addison Reed.
Darren Ruff will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone.
Well, you know he's feeling good at the plate, so he's already got two hits in this game, looking for another one.
Reed sets. First pitch on the way. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. This catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Boy, things are going from bad to worse so far. He's looking completely lost up there.
Runners are at first and second with one away. In the dirt here, but fortunately here, no advance. Ready to deliver the 1-2. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Now another 1-2. In the dirt, goes to third with it, and they will get him on the recovery down at third. So you can forget the wild pitch. It's a 2-5 putout. And now there are two gone. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2 is that that runner gets a head start from first with two away.
And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Now batting. Second baseman. Ready.
Freddy Galvis steps into the box and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far.
Well, this could be a huge inning or maybe the end of the inning. This is a pivotal at bat in one of the turning points of this ball game right here.
And he misses inside with that one. Ball one. That's wide, 2-0. Eric, what are you looking for here?
It's a fastball count, but he doesn't always play by the rules out there, so this could very well be a slider or something away. So, in other words, I have no idea.
Two and one after the foul ball there. Looking to minimize the damage here. 3-1 now. And I think he wanted to know where that one was. In danger now of a second walk out of the bullpen.
Not exactly providing relief. He's got to find it here somehow.
Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll flip it onto first. And with it, that ends the inning. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two left. Ninth inning coming up. Phillies lead this one 15-0. Rafael Vasquez will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
Yeah, whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
Now here's the pitch. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Here it comes. Line toward right center. And they'll start this inning off with a base hit as that one's through.
Well, this is quickly becoming a situation where you'd like your guy to hit the complete game, but once you get into that 115, 120 range, you have to be concerned.
A.J. Pollock will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot 0 for 3 thus far.
Well, guys, it just hasn't been his day. You know, sometimes cleanup hitters are sort of all or nothing type hitters. But hey, he's still got a chance to make an impact on this game right now.
On to first, and they get the double play.
Well, this ball is hit sharply, but you'll see the pitch is working its way down in the strike zone, and that's very tough to elevate. It's going to wind up being an easy double play ball.
Danny Valencia will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. Now the 0-1. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. And now this crowd of 27,000 plus rise to their feet. And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2. Still no fastballs in the at-bat. It's been all off speed.
That's definitely by design. He's such a good fastball hitter. You don't want to give in to his strength.
And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2.
He tried to get him to bite on that pitch, but it was way out of the zone there. It didn't even tempt him. Now he'll need to make a much better pitch here on a 3-2 count.
And that misses for ball four.
Hey, that's a great job to work out the walk there.
That's one thing managers like to see. You got to die hard at the plate, even down to your final out. You never know in this game.
Quentin Berry will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk.
Yeah, nothing going on earlier in this inning, but a chance to make some noise right here. Those kind of walks often seem to come back and bite guys somehow.
Changeup called strike one. Two out with the man at first. And this is swung on and missed, so the Diamondbacks are down to their final strike now.
And we've seen guys swing at that four-seam riding fastball up in the zone, but you're never going to get on top of that thing when it's up that high.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout this game. He was completely in charge, essentially, from pitch one. And now he finishes off a masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. And guys, you can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, definitely no debate as far as I'm concerned. He was really in complete control the whole way through. Only really got into trouble a few times, and he winds up with a complete game shutout.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjian. This has been a presentation.